You're welcome back. This is Firecrackers. Wherever you're watching from around the world, we are live from our studios here in Lagos, Nigeria. I am Kelly Egiga. Let's get things started tonight as we get some perspective from Abuja, the nation's capital, where Aisha Yesufu is standing by, the co-founder of the Bring Back Our Girls. She's also a social political activist. She joins us live from the nation's capital, Abuja. We also have Jonathan Asake, the president of the Southern Kaduna People's Union, SOKAPU. He also joins us from Abuja, the nation's capital. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining me on the show this evening. Let me begin with you, Aisha. There are unconfirmed reports just yet about the release of the schoolgirls, the Jangebe schoolgirls. Well, unconfirmed reports just yet. But how are you responding to this report of the release of the girls, if that is the case, as well as the release of the Kagara schoolboys as well in Niger State a few days ago, Saturday rather, to be precise?
Leave the parents and family members, the loved ones of the school children, having their children back is always something that anyone would wish for. But at the same time, it's appalling the rate at which it seems as if the children of the poor are being used as pawn in this whole whatever it is, shenanigans that is going on. They are not protected and they're allowed to be abducted. And it seems as if the government comes out, brings them back and be praising themselves. It's enough. These are little children. These are human beings. They are not just cargoes to be used anyhow. And I think it's very important and it's very imperative that the government starts really taking the protection of lives and property very seriously.
Well, Aisha, what do you say about the what would you say rather about the efforts of the government? I mean, the girls, according to unconfirmed reports, they have been released. Can't you take a moment and commend the efforts of the government, you think?
Well, I think when you are abducted and you are released back to your family, I would take that moment and commend the government. Until then, I'm not in the business of commending government. The school children were not supposed to have been taken in the first place. The primary responsibility of any government is the protection of lives and properties. And any government that cannot protect the lives and properties of its citizens is not fit to be called a government. And in the school children, the government failed in protecting their lives and properties. They allowed them to be traumatized, to spend days with kidnappers, to go through only God knows what you and I cannot even begin to imagine. And so bringing them back is not doing them a favor, is their right as enshrined in the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. And I think our business should be that as citizens of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, people who are not slaves, we should be protected. It is not to go on and start commending government. Thank you.
All right, Aisha, stay with us. We will come back and stay with the children, especially what exactly you think plays out the aftermath of these kidnappings in terms of the psychology of the children. You know, I read a report where some of them were practically beaten to death. I mean, one practically said that he almost felt like dying. But maybe you could just shed light on that before I go to the SOKAPU president. What do you make of the aftermath of being kidnapped, the trauma of being kidnapped? Do you think that many of these children are able to recover easily and do even have structures in place to help rehabilitate such children after being kidnapped and all and released?
This question of yours does tell us that there's nothing to commend this government about. Children are being traumatized, and this trauma is a trauma that will last them a lifetime. And the effect of this trauma, we don't even understand what it means. We are not even dealing with it. We are not even getting to grasp really the reality of it, or they will suffer from post-traumatic stress disorder probably for the rest of their lives. And unfortunately, we do not have a system here to be able to take care of them. I met a Chibok girl, one of the Chibok girls, who had escaped in 2014 when they were abducted. She jumped out of the moving truck when they were being carried away. So she did not even get to the camp to even stay there. But she was so traumatized that even when you see her, if you leave her alone in a room, the way she's so shaken. And so this is not a mere thing where you're saying, oh, they have been taken away, they've been brought back, clap for government. No, we're joking with the lives of our citizens. We're playing with the lives of citizens, especially children. And beyond the children who are being taken away, what about all of our children all over Nigeria who are now afraid to go to their classes, afraid to go to their school, because at the back of their mind, they're thinking, is it my school that they will come to next? So I think for me, honestly, we really need to hold our government absolutely accountable and really ensure that they do the needful. It's not, like I said earlier, in our business to be recommending the government. And if the government is really, if it has a hand in those whole shenanigans, because they are waiting for them to be praised, so that because they haven't done anything to be commended for, this is their way of getting commendation, then I must say that would be utterly and absolutely sickening.